Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are good and fine. My name is Kausalya. I am working in Sri Sathya Sai High School as a science teacher. So, in the before video, we learned about our universe. And today, we will learn an interesting topic. And what is the topic? The topic is about plants and their parts. So today's topic is about plants and their parts. So plants, generally every day we need food. We all the living birds and animals and the human beings, we all need food. So where we get the food from? We get the food from the plants. Okay, so we get food from the plants, and these plants we can see everywhere. And plants are in green color. Most of the plants are in green color. So is the plant are living thing or non-living thing? So plants are also living things. So plants are also living things. Why? They can also breathe and they can also grow and they can also reproduce. So that's why plants are also living things. Is plants are helpful to us or not? Plants are also very helpful to us. Why? They give us fruits, vegetables, different types of flowers, and for our breath, for all the life food, the most essential what now? Oxygen gas. Where we get from that gas? We get that gas from the plants. What is the gas? This oxygen gas we get from the plants. And many birds and many animals, they make their shelter on these plants. So plants are very, very useful to us, and we get some medicines from the plants also. That's why plants are very helpful. Now let us know where the plants are grow. Plants can grow in water or on the land, and in desert also plants can grow. So now know how plants can grow. So plants can grow from a seed. So plants are grow from a seed. The process by which a plant is a seed is growth into a plant, that process is called germination. So what is the germination? What is the germination meaning? The germination means the process by which a seed grows into a plant. That process is called germination. Means a seed, after some months a seed becomes to a plant. And this also happens in a process, and this process is called germination. So what a seed or what a plant need to grow? So plants need air, water, gas, means air, water, soil, and sunlight. So what is a seed or a plant need to grow? Now they need air, water, soil, and sunlight. These four things are very important to grow a seed into a plant. These four are very important. This helps a seed to grow into a plant. So this process is called germination. Okay. All plants are look same? No, plants are different from one another. So how can we identify the plants? How can we identify? Now all plants have their different flower, different leaves, different stem. So we identify different fruit also. So we identify by them. What now? Now all the plants we identify by their flower, fruit, and their leaf and their stem. We can identify by the plants. Which plants are what? We can identify by this. This is helps to identify the plants. Okay. Now let us know about how many types of plants. Plants are in 5 types. So plants are in 5. Okay children. So plants are in 5 types. So what are they? Nut trees, herbs, shrubs, climbers and creepers. So these are the 5 types of plants. Let us know about trees. What is trees? Now the very strong plants are called trees. Very strong plants are called trees. They can live for many years. These trees can live for many years, and these trees stem is very strong and woody. These trees stems are very strong. Name of some trees, examples of some trees: mango tree or neem tree. These are example of trees. Now let us know about herbs. Herbs are very small plants, and their stems are in green color. The stems of herbs are in green, and they can stand erect. So what is the examples of herbs are mint, coriander, grass. These are the examples of herbs. Now let us know about shrubs. So what is shrubs? Now the plants, they are taller than the herbs. These shrubs are made tall plants than the herbs, and these shrubs are bushy plants. These shrubs plants are bushy, and their stems are also strong, and they have many branches. And examples of shrubs are rose plant, jasmine plant. This is the example of shrubs. Climbers, they cannot stand straight. Why now? Their stems are very weak. They cannot stand straight. They need a support to stand straight. Example of climbers are money plant, pea plant. Generally, you can see in your house, money plant can stand straight. No, we give a support to stand straight. So plants are called climbers. Now let us know about creeper. Creeper, this creep on the ground. This creeper means creep. Then means what? Now these plants are creep on the ground. Because of their heavy and big fruits, they cannot stand straight. They creep on the ground. And the example of creepers are pumpkin tree and watermelon tree. These are the example of creeper. Okay. And some plants grows in water, and the plants which are grows in water, that plant are called aquatic plants. The plants which are grows in water, that plants are called aquatic plants. Okay, an example of aquatic plants are water lily and lotus. Okay, these plants are grows in water. So these plants are called aquatic plants. Why na? They grows in the water. So these plants are called aquatic plants. And some plants are also grows in desert. The plants which are grows in desert, that's plant are desert plant. Means which plant can grow in desert? Now, okay, the plant which grows in desert area, example is cactus. Cactus grows in desert. Okay, children, this is about the types of plants. Now we will learn about the parts of a plant. Okay, now we will learn about parts of a plant. As all we have different types of body parts, like that plants, they have also types of parts, and all the parts have their special functions. As like us, parts, plants have also many parts. These parts are helps a plant to reproduce. And growth and grow. That's a this plant. The parts of the plants are helps the plant to reproduce, to grow, and to survive. Okay. So plants have different parts. What are them? The flowers, fruits, stems, root, branches. Okay, flower, leaf, fruits, stem, root. These are the parts of a plant. Okay, the part which we can see above the soil, that part is called shoot. And the part which is below the soil, soil means this root, this part, this one is called roots of plant. So above the soil, this part is called shoot of plant, and under the soil, which under the soil, and that part is called root of the plant. This part is called a shoot of the plant, and this part is called root of the plant. And these all the parts of the plants helps to reproduce and means to function. Okay, these parts are helps a plant for making, distributing, and storing food. Okay, these plants parts are helps a plant for the making, restoring, and distributing. So these parts of the plants are helps to making, restoring, and distributing the food. Okay, now let us know about stem. So what is stem? This part is called stem, and this part is hold the soil tightly. Okay, this stem is hold the soil tightly, and it observe the stem. It's very strong and woody part, and it hold the soil very tightly. That's why the plant cannot move from that place. Some plants of the stems we eat. Some plants of the stems we eat. That are we eat sugarcane or ginger. That are the stem of the plants, and we eat that stem. Next one is about leaves. Okay, next one is about leaves. Leaves is very important part to the plant. Why now? The leaves are prepare their food for the plants, and which food is help the plants to growth. So using sunlight the plants prepare the food, and the root absorb the water and the nutrition from the soil and it gives that to the leaf, and using the sunlight the leaf prepare the food for the plant, and this all process is called photosynthesis. The process which a leaf make the food, that process is called photosynthesis. That process is called photosynthesis. Okay, and we eat some leaf, we eat leaves of some plants. Now what? Now we eat curry leaf, coriander leaf, and spinach. These leaves we eat. Now let us know about the root. Root absorb water and the nutrition from the soil, and it hold the plant tightly under the soil. And in some plants, the plants are also store their food under this root, and we eat that root of some plants. What are they now? We eat potato, carrot, onion, or radish. They are the roots of the plants which are under the soil. So this is about root, stem, and leaf. Now let us know about flower. And this, in the plants, flower are very attractive part. Now why it looks very beautiful? As all the plants have different types of leaves, different types of root, and different types of stem, and flowers are also different from to another. And these plants are very attractive, and these flowers, we generally use flowers when in our festivals or in puja, or we decorate our home with these flowers. And the honeybees, they get honey from these flowers. Okay, now let us know about fruit. Fruit we eat fruits of different plants, and inside the fruit there is a seed, and that seed is help us to reproduce the plant. Inside the fruit there is a seed, and the seed is help to reproduce the plant again. From that seed we get the same type of plant. This is about the plant and their parts. Okay, so children, hope you all understood the topic very well, and try to plant more and more trees. Okay, try to plant more and more trees, and tell others to cut down the trees also. So children, these trees increases the beauty in our universe. So try to plant more and more trees, because, and encourage others to also to plantation more trees, because more plantation is more better future and green future. So this is about the plants and their parts. Thank you all. After this video we will send a worksheet to you, and complete the worksheets carefully. Thank you.